Alright, YouTube, I thought I'd begin this now, just because I'm really super excited, more excited than I've been for any campaign ever, even for the original Shogun 2 campaign, and I don't know how it's going to work out, but I'm going to do a Rise of the Samurai Kiso Minamoto campaign here. Now, when I play without fraps on, I can actually get, my guess is around 20 to 30 frames per second, which is outstanding for me. On these kind of graphics, I'm sorry I don't have 16 by 9, but, you know, I'm going to play like this simply because I like it, and this campaign is partly for your benefit and, you know, a lot for mine, because I'm really looking forward to this campaign. So, I started one of these before, and I actually got quite, it was doing pretty darn well. So hopefully I can repeat that, and let me read you a little bit about these Kiso Minamoto. I told you guys a little bit about it in my my first look video, sort of. These guys are relentless, is their one word. They're blessed by Raijin. They have plus 20% to campaign movement range for armies. That's going to be pretty darn helpful. Speedy mobilization, minus 1 to recruitment time for samurai units, very helpful. The foot samurai only have 1 recruitment speed, whereas the attendants have 2, which is kind of interesting. War fervor, minus 20% to the rate at which bunka arts are mastered. Bunka is kind of like Bushido, but this was before Bushido, because this is when the samurai pretty much were founded. They have first samurai Bushi art already mastered, so some of my arts are already mastered. I'm going to read this real quick. You can skip forward a little bit if you don't want to listen to me talk. Perfectly understand. I don't like listening to me talk either. The Minamoto are a cadet branch of the imperial family, directly descended from the Emperor Seiwa. They are, in fact, very distant cousins to the Taira, and family arguments tend to get out of hand very quickly. This was certainly the case for the Minamoto during and after the Hogen and Heiji disturbances of 1156 and 1160. In all but name, these small wars saw the Minamoto almost destroyed by the Taira family. After 1160, the Minamoto leaders and lesser family who had not been killed were banished from court, and the Taira looked unassailable. Then the Taira went too far, and, ignoring Prince Mochihito's legitimate claims to the throne, made sure that a Taira descendant, on his mother's side, became the new emperor. Prince Mochihito turned to the Minamoto for help, and in 1180, warfare erupted. There were many scores to settle, not least the many executions on Taira orders. And because I know a little bit about this campaign, I will actually throw in tidbits here and there about the little facts of knowledge that I know. Anyways, so it's going to be an easy campaign. I don't really want too much of a challenge. This is simply to enjoy the game. It's going to be short campaign mode. Battle realism mode is off. So let's head to it. So, I'm actually going to start talking at this moment here, and basically, this Genpei War, which is the war that this Rise of the Samurai is focusing on, this immediately followed the Heiji Uprising, pretty much, and basically during that, the Minamoto clan were pretty much wiped out by the Taira clan, and all that we really left were couple kids that were banished, and both of the Minamoto guys.
The Sengoku Jidai was a time of war, but those who say Japan has never seen the like have short memories. Long before the Ashikaga Shogunate, 400 years of peace were shattered by the Genpei War. Amaterasu, the Sun Goddess, watched over the emperors of Japan and gave them power. Their authority was absolute. An emperor could retire from the world and still have complete mastery over Japan. But now, imperial might is crumbling, weakened by 3 noble families. For many years, the Taira have secretly controlled the imperial court. Sophisticated, cunning, ruthless. They plot against any challengers to their hidden power. The Minamoto are proud warriors. Their pleasure is battle. That and the destruction of their enemies. The Fujiwara were once the most powerful family in Japan. But now, they only dream of power. After years of careful planning, the Taira are finally ready to make their move. The Miyamoto intend to block with all their might. Meanwhile, the Fujiwara watch and wait. Perhaps this moment is a chance to right wrongs. The imperial peace is at an end. War is coming, and blood will flow. We are the Minamoto, forced into exile by the Taira, following their overthrow of the Fujiwara regency.
No one really wants to hear that.
The Genpei War are each split into two families. The principal object of the campaign game is to achieve hegemony over the other major families and minor lords, either through conquest or by spreading our family's influence throughout the provinces. Fame still gauges how powerful and dangerous our family is perceived as being within Japan. But there is no shogunate to overthrow in order to achieve victory. If we become too powerful, Emperor Go-Shirakawa will declare us an enemy of the state, at which point all other families will move to attack us, including our sister family.
Thank you. Well, so, one moment. Just gotta turn the sound down. There we go. Alright, so here you can see the campaign map. It runs much smoother when I don't have fraps running at all. Like I can get, as I said, 20 to 30 in my estimate frame rates. But this will have to do. It's not that bad, at least it doesn't seem like it's that bad. It's not smooth, but it's at least not rough. So you can see that they did revamp the campaign map a lot. There aren't towering mountains at all now. The mountains are reasonably scaled. There are a couple really tall mountains, like this is Mount Fuji. Oh, I was blanking on the name, and even that might not be correct. That would be really embarrassing if I misnamed that. But you can see a very, very beautiful campaign map. This is on the lowest possible settings, so I'm pretty sure you'll see from like some of the big name YouTubers, at least some of the bigger name YouTubers, some really, really nice graphical campaign map that you guys will be astounded by. But anyways, this is the best I can offer, and please, you know, judge me on my commentary, not on my graphics. Anyways, so looks like we have two provinces to start out with. We have North Shinano and South Shinano. And South Shinano is our stronghold, it looks like. So North Shinano here is just an out branch. We have this one guy here. This is a Junsatsushi. And these guys are kind of like the Metsuke. They can bribe other... here, let's actually take a look at what... Encyclopedia... characters, or as the samurai characters, these guys here. These guys are able to bribe. They're able to oversee. They're able to pay off. I don't know what that is, but I can just check right here real quick. Payoffs. They can detect and pay off rival agents, and this is their main thing: request allegiance. Junsatsushi is able to convince the population of a castle town aligned to another family and its garrison to pledge their allegiance to the family of his lord. It is not possible to request allegiance in a province where your family's influence is less than 50%. In this game, it's not religion, it's influence. To request allegiance, simply select your Junsatsushi, right-click on the target agent, and select Request Allegiance from the options presented to you. However, bear in mind that there is a chance that your agent might be caught and executed should he fail. Your Junsatsushi will also passively spread his family's influence in a province by his presence alone, thereby making it more likely that a subsequent request for allegiance will be successful. So he's kind of like a half Metsuke, half monk, in that he can kind of incite revolt, except not revolt. So let's actually start moving him down here to Kai. And I will be able to show you guys here the first enemy settlement. This is the Takeda. You can see their flag, but it's now all white and blue. If I double click this, we can see in here we have their influence. They are 80% Minamoto, and they're 10% Taira and 10% Fujiwara. Their Minamoto influence is growing at 1.5 because there's a Minamoto supporter present. That's my Junsatsushi. They are also ruling family favors the Minamoto, and these are just the three major clans. With my guy here, they will even further, be influenced by us. And if you request an alliance with them, they will be even further. And then that's when you request allegiance. And these guys basically go completely over to you. It's not like a vassal, but they are now your province. I have 4,000 to spend. You can see that there are tons of new buildings here. So we have the town that goes to the stronghold, consumes food too. Fortified defenses, unlocks an additional construction slot. We already have two construction slots each here. You can see here that this is kind of like... it's kind of like a barracks, pretty much. So you can get either the muster field or the town watch here. Town watch gives you more defending units, but it doesn't give you less recruitment capacity. And then this one over here gives you less defending retainers, but it allows you better recruitment capacity, so you can recruit two guys in that, two guys at one time instead of one. And this is already our stronghold, our capital, so we can already recruit two guys here. Over here we have the Bushi training grounds. This is pretty much, this is a barracks as well. So over here you can see if I upgrade this, we will be able to recruit foot samurai, the only samurai unit in the game. We can already recruit bow attendants and sword attendants. Roads cost a bazillion, because that's kind of a pretty good adjustment to the game. And the farms are kind of interesting. You can see here we have an undeveloped farm. We can either upgrade it to dry field agriculture, which provides 2 food and plus 510 wealth from farms, or we can do this and upgrade the pastures. That gives us less wealth from farms, same growth, but one less food, but it enables the recruitment of cavalry in the province. So I think once I take Kai, either through my Junsatsushi or by conquering it military with my military, I will upgrade that to the pasture there. But otherwise, I'm going to do all these into dry field agriculture. And I'm only doing this it's going to be kind of fun, I think, to try and go through and recreate the original Shogun 2 campaign. So kind of like in Kai, we'd make this place like horses. So we'd get some horse buildings in here so that eventually it could become the Kai that we know today, and Takeda would be horse guys. Over here I might, make these guys markets and, stuff like that. Although there isn't really a market. Anyways, so you can see my army here. This is, where is he? This guy, Minamoto Yoshinaka. This guy is the quintessential samurai there. He's the hero samurai of them all. He's like what people think of when they think samurai. Minamoto Yoshinaka, that's the guy. And that's not me saying it. That's not my opinion. That's what he was. Anyways, so I've got him, and I've got this Ishai Kanahira. I've got one sword attendant, two Naginata levies, and a bow attendant and a bow levy. So I'm actually going to first go into diplomacy and try trading with, and look at that, I can trade with bazillions of people. And that's pretty much what I'm going to do. I'm going to save. I have done a little bit of this campaign before, and I was actually doing quite well. But I'm going to try and attack these Toki guys, try and get into this plain area here, because this is a really nice area to control. It's one of the three plains in Japan. So I'm going to attack the Toki. I'm going to request a trade with everyone else here. So request trade. All right, request trade with the Daisuke. Request trade with the Edo. Request trade with the Honda, like Honda Civic. They were indeed a family back at this time. Let's request a trade with the Li. They will probably want 60 gold. Yep, there we go. I'll accept that, just for now. We will get more from it than we would otherwise. Kajiwara, request a trade. Let's keep going. I must request a trade with Kiyohara. This is kind of boring right here, but we're getting quite a bit of income. Trading doesn't do quite as much income per trading as it did in the other game. You can see here, I would get 66 trade from that clan, 63 from that clan, and 66 from the Toki. And that's kind of, you know, realistic. They didn't have quite the number of goods as they had in the Sengoku period to trade. One more right there, the Nitta. There we go. Very good. And I'm just going to leave this blank here until I have an army ready to attack them. And that should be pretty soon, so I'm going to indeed get this right there. Get my daimyo into that army. And get that general out. Oops. There we go. Okay, money-wise, building things. Let's see. North Shinano, we have an empty site here. And I think it would be really nice to get Bushi Training Grounds. I don't know. Yeah, Bushi Training Grounds goes to the Foot Samurai. So if we want to go that route, we would get this Bushi Training Grounds. School at this rate, don't really like it. I do have to deal with my arts still. Koyu Training Grounds, this would eventually get me Warrior Monks, but I need to couple that with the Buddhist Sanctuary, so I will wait on that. Anyways, the Monks are not nearly, they're not as good as the Foot Samurai, so I think I will go with the Bushi Training Grounds there. I'll go with the Dry Field Agriculture, and I'll even burn this one to get the Dry Field Agriculture eventually. Actually, I'm going to get this Bushi School first. Master of the Arts here, you can see we already have Budo, +1 defense for all units and +2 charge bonus for all units, and Bushi, +2 charge bonus for all units and enables the Bushi school. And over here, I think I'll actually go for this, Chinese learning. That gives +4 to diplomatic relations and increase the trade income by 10%. Pretty nice. So that's pretty much all that I can do for right now. Eventually what I'll do is I will request allegiance from these guys. Maybe next turn I'll request their alliance and then their allegiance. An alliance and allegiance are different, remember. Alrighty, so there we go. Let's end that turn. Pretty successful. Actually, wait a second. This is not allowed. Let's get some sword attendants in here. Let's wait on that Bushi school. Get some more sword attendants. Over here we need some military here to protect ourselves. That's good. We can get the Bushi Dojo next time, because I want enough military to attack these Toki before they can build up a military. So, there we go. Now we end the turn. And there are, you know, the 6 initial families here, and there will actually be lots of mini-clans. It's not like there are only 3 families, it's just that there are only 3 families that you can play as. There are lots of these other little guys, just like in the original Shogun. And you'll see some names passing through here. Kitabatake is one. Satake, Ashikaga was right there. Matsuda is kind of like Matsuda. Uwaji, whatever they're called. Oh, the Daisuke broke the trade agreement. And it says here, obtain the allegiance of any province here, and we will get +10% to the success chance of Jinatsu Sasashi. I need to get that name down. So, what we're going to do here is we're going to request the allegiance. Sorry, no. Request alliance. See, they will accept. Now let's take a look in at Kai here. They're 84.6% Minamoto, so now would be an excellent time. Not only that, they moved out their army, which will make this cost a lot less. So it only costs 816. We have a very good chance of success. No, they declined my allegiance. Okay, I'll do that next turn, and it should work next turn. Okay, what can we do here? Next turn, I will get these guys, the sword attendants, and join them up with my army. I will get this Bushi school there. I have 364 left to spend. I don't want to spend that. Get more money next turn. Alrighty, warriors recruited, we know. But yeah, those levies are really not very powerful stuff. That's why I want the sword attendants and eventually the foot samurai. Foot samurai are very low in number, but they're pretty nice. They're pretty nice units. Alrighty, financially, trading. You can see that we're not trading with anyone really a lot. 66 is our max. Not very good. But I think eventually that actually goes up. Clan management. Let's actually change this general from being the commissioner for warfare to the commissioner for finance. Because finance gives us more money, which is what we want. You definitely want money in these early stages of the game.